not complain or laugh or do anything besides work. Whatever you thought, whatever you were, does not matter. You are no one now. You mean nothing. Who are you?
Aaron?
No, I don't need them. I've been treated so wrong. I've been treated so wrong.
Who are you?
As if I'm the one.
I'm the slow dying fly. I'm frost killing now.
Who are you?
No one.
Wake up, America. Slavery is happening here. It's happening now.
It's human trafficking. End of story. It's repulsive.
There are two types of human trafficking: labor trafficking and sex trafficking. Labor trafficking is the use of force, fraud, or coercion in order to have cheap, sometimes free, physical labor. Some examples of labor trafficking include debt bondage and involuntary servitude. Sex trafficking is the use of force, fraud, or coercion as a means to get another person to participate in commercial sex. Common types of sex trafficking are prostitution and pornography. You do not need to prove the use of force, fraud, or coercion in victims under the age of 18, as you would in cases dealing with adults. If it's a minor in commercial sex, it's considered human trafficking. No ifs, ands, or buts. Yes, human trafficking is illegal. There are, however, a low number of statutes dealing with trafficking. Due to the low number of statutes and the high burden of proof required to prosecute, there are very few prosecutions of human trafficking. The state of Kentucky currently had zero successful prosecutions under the title of human trafficking. Simply put, human trafficking is a low-risk and high-profit business. Victims rarely speak against the perpetrators due to fear of retaliation or deportation. It's not uncommon for traffickers to bribe the law enforcement to look the other way. Few traffickers that are caught are often charged with lesser crimes, such as drug trafficking, tax fraud, or prostitution.
I'm going to make you an offer. Your life. Your life.
Are you volunteering?
I don't have a choice, do I?
Caroline, actions have consequences, but what we do helps people. If you become a part of that, it can help you.
Right. You're just looking out for me.
Perhaps better than you have.
This is where you'll spend the majority of your non-engagement time.
When does the hankering for tasty brains kick in? These people are zombies.
We call them actives. This isn't the end of your life.
Then why do I feel like I'm walking to the gallows?
Dollhouse, his most recent show, is probably the greatest example of human trafficking in Joss Whedon's filmography. This show follows the premise of people entering into a contract and having their personalities wiped. They are then imprinted with new personalities, new skills, and a whole new person. While the dolls are said to have willingly signed up for this, there are signs that blackmail may have been used. In the first episode, the primary protagonist, Echo, is asked if she's sure about signing the contract. She replies that it is not as if she has much of a choice. She is then forced to do assignments ranging from infiltrating a cult or just having kinky sex. Her memory is wiped after each engagement.
There's one thing people will always need is slaves.
Well, some of the versions of the story say the dolls themselves are volunteers.
While the show realistically portrays the acts and various types of human trafficking, it does not accurately portray the conditions in which most victims live.
Hey, who you calling cow, mister?
Um,
A fine old cow. Good cow. Sure. Pretty pricey to market.
The portrayal of trafficking in Buffy and Angel is quite different. For one, it's not a prevalent theme of the shows. Each of these series have had just a few episodes on the subject. In Buffy, the episode was the season 3 opener, Anne. In this episode, runaway teenagers are taken to a hell dimension and forced to work until they are too old. Then they are spit back out into the human dimension. On Angel, trafficking also takes place in another hell dimension. Here, humans are referred to as cows and are treated as slaves, forced to do whatever the Pylians tell them they must do. They are considered the lowest type of creatures and earn no respect.
I always knew I would come here. Sooner or later. I knew I belonged here.
Where?
Hell.
This isn't hell.
Isn't it? What is hell but the total absence of hope? The substance, the tactile proof of despair. Ouch. You're right, Lily. This is where you've been heading all your life.
In these shows, Joss does not portray the traffickers as human. Instead, he demonizes them, in a very literal sense of the word. Both of these shows emphasize that all types of people are trafficked. On Buffy, the trafficker focuses primarily on strong and healthy teenage runaways, people who wouldn't be missed. In Angel, one of the victims is a very brilliant physics student who is simply in the wrong place at the wrong time.
They called you Fred. You were studying to be a physicist. You disappeared from a library in Los Angeles 5 years ago.
And my head still.
There is one flaw in his portrayal of trafficking in Buffy and Angel, and that is how easily it is overcome by the victims. Unfortunately, in the real world, you cannot count on a superhero to come. As G.I. Joe says, the more you know. Research the subject. Tell your friends. Volunteer at women's shelters. Be aware of what you're buying and try to stick to primarily fair trade products when you can. Be aware of those around you, and if you suspect human trafficking, report it to an official. Even if you're wrong, at least you're tried. Be wary of strip clubs, massage parlors, and even common pornography. These are hotbeds for human trafficking. That is not to say that all strip clubs or pornographic films use trafficking to find their talent, but it is important to be aware that it does happen. And remember, knowledge is power. Maybe with this knowledge, you could be something too.
No, Leslie, I think I've heard enough. You want me to go back where we'd be slaves? Sorry, not doing that.
Saying people
are
free, don't they?
Who are you?
I'm Buffy, the vampire slayer.